My name is Auntie Roro. Welcome to your favorite family show, Ask Auntie Roro. And on this show, I'll be answering all of your questions from every single area of life. So on this show, as I take up the audacious task of answering all of your difficult questions, let me quickly throw my disclaimer out there. Do note that every solution, every advice is followed strictly at doer's risk. So I have two questions I'll be tackling today, but before I tackle those questions, if you are new here, let me welcome you to my YouTube channel, Auntie Roro, where I film about storytelling, lifestyle, and humor. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel and do take that a step further by also following me on my Instagram page at @aderonkeaddex. Like my videos, comment on them, and you can also share them within your network. Thank you very much. So to my first question of the day, I want you to listen very carefully to my question. Does hard work really beat talent like most people claim? Does hard work really beat talent like most people claim? The eternal war between talent and hard work. I think this quote must have been developed when people claim that they don't have any talent too, and so they are not doing anything, you know, they are not going to job, they are not going for any work. The question is, if you don't work, how do you want to eat? Eh? But how many of you have seen all those? How many of you have seen Project Film? Olagbara. I'm sure some of the people that have gone for the audition have taken quotes like this very seriously. They took it to the extreme. They don't have any singing voice. Some of them are like me in singing arena. They will be singing something like, I'm gonna swim on the chandelier. Can you imagine? They will now be disgracing us on national TV. Talent matters you. However, talent is not enough, according to John Maxwell. Talent is never enough. And you know that we don't have talents to the same degree. So I think what that quote is saying is, if my own degree of talent is less, but I put in more hard work than another person who has more talent but put in less hard work, I have a higher chance of coming out better than that person. And it's just like me now saying I want to go and put in for Project Film. Please, if you ever see me on Project Film, it is certainly not me. Thank you very much. On to my second question. Why do people choose to stay single? Auntie Roro, why do people choose to stay single? Why SP people choose to remain single? Because they don't want to marry. Being married and being single are two of many things that are mutually exclusive. That means that they cannot occur together. You cannot be married and be single at the same time. Although it's like some of us are not really aware that you cannot be single and be married at the same time. Honestly, some people even confuse being married for being single. Or how do you explain the activity of a married person on a dating site? It's like us mistaking the president's promptness for weakness. For any person we one day single, now because they no one marry. Simple. And this marks the end of Ask Auntie Roro sessions for today. Let's meet again by 8 p.m. next week, next Saturday, for another session. You know, another session with Ask Auntie Roro. And in case you have any question, you can send it to me during the week. You can send it to auntieroro1@gmail.com, or you can just comment below and I'll take it up from there and you get answers to your question. It's all on a lighter note, nothing serious. Till we meet next week, I want you to stay safe. I don't want to be talking about Nigerian situation because I tell you, I have chosen to always speak positive about Nigerian situation. Nigeria, they got nothing on my spirit, man. My spirit is bigger than everything happening in this Nigeria. I love you so much. I want you to be there next week. Catch ya later.